Abner, did you notice that sound just then?
What?
Was it our ring?
Oh, did the telephone ring?
Oh, for pity's sake. Hello, John Downstore.
I'm going out waiting.
Yeah, this is Lemon Abner.
And now let's see what's going on down in Pine Ridge.
Grandpap, are you sure that was Squire Skimp that you seen?
Sure, I'm sure. I'd know that Squire anywhere. I stood right there before I opened the door and watched him choke that big red X right there on the dress goods counter. Then I kind of made a little noise out there, and he skedaddled right through the feed room. He more than likely thinks I never seen him.
Well, now, you only seen him from the back, though, Grandpap. You couldn't prove it was Squire.
Hey, you don't have to take my word for it, Abner, but I seen him. I can tell the way Squire's pants droops there in the back. And he's the only feller in town who wears one of them Panama hats in the wintertime.
Oh, yeah, he's proud of that Panama hat, all right. Don't even take it off when he goes in the house.
Just loves and admires that hat. Won't even take it off while he's eating.
No. Well, of course, now, if a woman comes in the room while he's having supper, he will get up and tip his hat, though. He's polite, I'll say that fine.
Reckon how he got mixed up with the Red X gang. Squire usual works alone. Too stingy to let anybody else in on any of his deals.
Well, now, maybe this Red X gang's got something on Squire. There's a whole lot we don't know about Squire Skimp before you come to Pine Ridge.
Yeah, you ain't just whistling Dixie, bud.
Huh?
Nothing. I wouldn't put nothing past old Squire. I never could stand that varmint ever since he moved here.
Well, I think you're prejudiced, old sometimes, Grandpa.
Just can't stand him.
He might be a better man you think he is, old.
Well, I hope I never find it out, because then I'd have to start liking him, and I just can't stand the varmint.
Well, I'll admit I don't see how you could be wrong, but on the other hand, I don't see how come Squire would be mixed up with some gang that's threatening to kill Lum.
Nobody never threatened to kill Lum. They just warned him not to take that trunk to the police or else, they said.
Yeah, well, I don't believe them gangs ever comes right out and says what they're going to do, though. They just get you to imagining stuff. And you can imagine anything.
Well, I know what I seen, and you and Lum can take it or leave it. I don't care. Whereabouts is Lum at now, down in that hole?
Yeah, he's down there looking over some more jewelry in the trunk. Kind of hard to see him too good, you know, it's just that coal oil lantern he's got down there.
Well, Lum don't think I just imagined I seen Squire marking that X on the counter, does he?
I don't know, Grandpa. I know he hates to think that Squire belonged to some gang that's out to kill him.
Well, maybe Squire's got himself into a mess where he can't help himself. This gang might be making him do what they want him to do. Wait a second. Look at yonder, Abner. Old Squire's coming up out there right now.
Oh.
I believe he's looking at something on the step there.
Oh, if I had the wings
this thing gives me the creeps.
Well, if Squire is part of the Red X gang, we sure don't want him to know where Lum's at. Now, don't you go accusing Squire yet, though. But, oh, come in, Squire.
Yeah, howdy, Squire.
Well, gentlemen, Abner, I just noticed a brand new Red X mark out there on the step. This thing is getting serious here, Abner.
How do you know it's brand new, Squire?
How's that, Grandpa?
You heard me.
Oh, well, it wasn't so awful brand new. I noticed it when I was going by this morning.
Squire, that mark wasn't there till you got there just now.
Grandpa, I'm afraid your old eyes don't see as well as they used to. What I wanted...
My old eyes are good enough to see from the front of the Jot'em Down store clean to the back. Don't go telling me... Nobody can tell me how good I
am. Abner, I'd like to say a few words if this virtuous and venerable old gentleman here will kindly keep his trap shut for 1 second.
Who's a venerable old gentleman? You take that back.
Cut it out, Grandpap. What's on your mind, Squire?
Well, I've got to see Lum right away, especially since the place is getting all chalked up with red X's.
Well, Lum ain't here, Squire.
Great balls of fire. What's he doing, hiding out or something?
Well, don't ask me nothing about where Lum's at, Squire. I don't know.
Well, I've got this insurance policy all made out, and he'd better get it signed before something happens to him.
How much is it for, Squire?
Grandpap, if it's any of your business, it's for $10,000. And it covers any kind of death, from being murdered by a gang of thieves to giving up the ghost from a bee sting. In other words, it covers everything from homicide to insecticide.
Well, I wouldn't care how it happened if you just get $10,000 for it.
I've got everything covered in the policy.
What kind of a pigeon-toed policy is that?
Well, it's a good one. And on top of everything else out there, if there's any other possible way to die that isn't mentioned in here, there's some blank spaces in there where the deceased can fill in his favorite disease just before he shuffles off.
Hold on here, Squire. What kind of a company would put out a policy like that?
Yeah, I don't believe I ever heard of a company that'd give you that kind of insurance?
I don't believe there is such an insurance company.
Well, as a matter of fact, gentlemen, up to now, there hasn't been. I just formed the company myself not 15 minutes ago. And it's known as the M.K. Skimp Life Insurance and Indemnity Company of Arkansas.
Oh, prattle, prattle.
Squire, how could you afford to pay Lum $10,000 if he got killed? You ain't got $10,000.
No.
Well, I've got a few bonds, and then there's my house over there, Abner. And together with the other property I've got here and there, why, the whole thing amounts to a little over $10,000.
Squire, don't stand there and tell us you're going to take a chance of losing everything you own.
Special with this Red X gang after Lum.
Doing this for a good old Lum, I suppose.
Yes, I am. Lum is my friend, one of the finest men that ever drew breath. And I want to see that he is protected from the prime of manhood on down through the Valley of the Tears.
Fancy, fresh, fancy, fresh.
And on top of that, I could use a little ready cash right now. A little capital, income tax, folks are pinching me a little
bit. Yeah, already owe them $240.
That's exactly the amount of ready capital I need. Abner, I'll just leave this policy on the desk here. When Lum shows up, have him sign it and send it right over. I don't want to waste any more time. I'd like to see Lum all fixed up before that Red X gang strikes.
Well, I'll be a spavin-legged monkey's uncle. He's in an awful hurry to get Lum insured for some reason.
I just can't understand it, Grandpap. If Squire is a member of a gang that wants to murder Lum, why is he so dad blame anxious to have him take out that insurance policy?
I don't get it. I just don't get it. If the Red X gang does land on Lum, Squire stands a chance of losing every knock-kneed thing he's got.
It just don't figure out.
No, Abner, maybe I was seeing things yesterday. Maybe that wasn't Squire after all. Might have been one of them Red X fellers disguised to look like Squire.
Ah, bound you, that's it, Grandpap.
But I'll be dogged if old Squire didn't almost come right out and admit he just chalked up another Red X on the front step there.
Yeah, it did sound an awful lot like it. You kind of had him pinned down there and he wiggled out of it. I just don't know what to think.
Well, let's get old Lum up here and see what he thinks.
Yeah, Lum? Hey, Lum, come up here a second. Hey, look out the window and see if anybody's coming, Grandpap.
Are you and Grandpap all alone now, Edgar?
Yeah, come on up here, Lum.
Ain't nobody coming. Can't see us over a block.
Hey, Lum, we're in an awful mix-up here. Maybe you can help us figure something out. You see, Squire was just in here.
I heard the whole thing, Abner, and I'll swear I can't make no sense out of it neither. Has the Squire gone crazy or something?
He wants to insure you for everything under the sun. There's a policy right there. Wants you to hurry and sign it and get it over there to him.
I just can't figure it. If he is a member of the Red X gang and they're aiming to kill me to get that trunk, he's still got to turn over all of his property to me, or to my benefits. According to that insurance policy. If they kill me, he's got to pay for it.
And even if he ain't a member, he still knows they're after you for something.
Yeah, and he said the other day that Red X gang won't stop at nothing. I sat right here and heard him say it.
That's right. He said he knowed of a case.
Hold it a second, fellas. I'm getting an idea.
Uh-huh.
Granny's, I could just prove one thing, I'd have the whole business unsolved.
What's that, Mom?
Grandpap, are you sure that was Squire you seen in here yesterday chalking a Red X on the dress goods counter? Well, I sure of it up to now, but now I ain't so sure. Don't ask me to go into court and swear to it, Mom. Be doggone if I know what I seen now. I might have been dreaming.
Can't blame it all anyway.
I was only sure it was him making that Red X. Hold on here. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I got it. Squire ain't no member of the Red X gang. He's the whole dad blame gang himself.
Who they are, huh?
He just made up that Red X gang to scare me into buying an insurance policy. Keep from paying me back that $240.
How do you know that, Lum? Explain it.
Well, he's the whole gang, and he ain't going to kill me, so he's safe in selling me that policy. And he's the one that's been chalking up them Red X's all right. Grandpap, you wasn't dreaming. That was him you seen. Squire himself, the Red X gang in person.
Well, you can't prove he's been making them red chalk marks so long.
I can't.
No, sir.
Grandpap, didn't you accuse Squire of chalking a Red X on the steps just before he come in? Well, he done it all right. Look at that insurance policy. Some of the red chalk rubbed off of his fingers onto that paper. Look at there. Hey, granny's fellas, for once in my life, I've actually caught old Squire Skip red-handed. And I do mean red.